Hello everybody, Cone Dodger here, and welcome back to Let's Race with Cone. This is a new season with a new format. It is going to be back in iRacing once again, and it will be full-time iRacing, so we are going to do a full season, and by that I mean a full iRacing season, which is approximately 12 weeks, depending on drops and stuff like that. But things are going to be a little bit different this time. We are going to step down and go back to some Miata racing, which is a little bit below my actual iRating / class rating skill level, if you will. But it has been so long since I've done iRacing that I feel as though it's the right move. And it will bring back some more competitive racing nature to the series. Spec Miata racing, or this is not really spec Miata racing, but Miata racing in general is much tighter, close competition, and will probably be a little bit more interesting to watch. On top of that, there will also be some new elements to this series. If you see in the title, it is called the Charity Challenge, and that is because I've decided to give myself some penalties based on my performance. There will be penalties and there will be rewards, if you will, but all of them go to Child's Play Charity through Farlands or Bust. If you don't know what Farlands or Bust is, it is a Minecraft series by a fella named Kurt J. Mack. He is a major inspiration for me and was the main reason I started doing YouTube, Let's Plays, and all that kind of stuff. So I want to try and pay it forward and help out his quest to hit $50,000 this season on Farlands or Bust and give myself an incentive to keep myself donating and stuff like that. So everybody wins. So here's the rules. For every incident that I occur in a race, or incur, whatever you want to use there, I will donate $1. So if I get a 4x penalty, there you go, there's $4. For every position I lose in the race, 50 cents. So if I qualify first and I fall to 10th, bam, $5. $5 out my wallet and into Child's Play. And then we have some more kind of rare scenario type of deals, where if I hit a clean race and I win, instant $20. And that's to kind of cover the rare occurrence that happens, and it would be a $0. And if I have to redo a race, if I decide that my race was just awful, I blow an engine, I crash, whatever you have, I erase the total from the first race, $15, we get to try again, and then totals from that race count as well. So that is the premise of the series. I hope you enjoy, and we are going to jump into week number zero of this series, because this new season hasn't started yet, so we're going to do a practice race to knock off the rust and get things started. Alrighty, here we are at Summit Point in the Miata. Let this guy go.
You got one on your left.
Do a little warm-up. About 5 minutes before the race starts. Don't know where we will be starting. There is 93 people registered for this race, and the track suits about 20, so it breaks it down into groups of 20-ish, I think, and we'll kind of stack you together with people of your similar iRating or division, things like that. Somewhat your qualifying times, but that seems to be a little bit irrelevant at times. My qualifying time was terrible. I've actually just found a new setup. Normally, in the regular series, I'll be doing a lot of qualifying and a lot of practicing, but this week is intended. Whoa! Slow down, car. Is intended solely. I don't think that's the real Scott speed. Solely to knock off the rust and get back into the rhythm of things. And there is a lot of rust to knock off. I definitely again, have the whole butterflies thing going on. A lot of nerves that I had pretty much gotten over by the end of my first iRacing career, if you will. But it's certainly... let me go here. Certainly much more intense than, say, a Soto Corsa or any other kind of sim racing I've been doing lately. Even in a series such as this, If you don't know iRacing well, this is considered week 13, even though it's actually week 7 this season because of a short season. So basically they will launch two official series, Road and Oval. This one is obviously the Road one, it is in the Mazdas, and is basically the same format as the Mazda Advanced Cup we'll be doing. The difference is, it is not the Advanced Cup, so you can get rookies in here, you can get all sorts of different speed of drivers, and because it's week 13 and the lack of other things to do, there will be a lot of people. A lot of people. Now the Mazda Cups are always pretty popular anyway, but there's going to be probably a ton of people every race for these, and that's fine. Really just here. Oof, lost the nose. Fuck off. I'm not sure if I like the setup or not. It's faster. At its best, it certainly seems faster, but at times it seems to lose the nose pretty easily. I don't think that's going to be a huge problem in the race. It's going to be more about just staying on track and battling the attrition.
1:27.42.
It should be running 25s at least. That would be a decent race pace, I think. 26s would be not very good. Probably lose a bunch of spots. Usually how it goes in these kind of races is not many people will qualify. So I may be the last qualifier on time and start right mid-pack because half the people aren't going to qualify. Follow those guys right into that. Which is really annoying to me because then you get a bunch of people in the back who are super quick and have then got to weave their way up through the field. Well, looks like that's it for warm-up. It'll kick us out any second now. Any second now. Looks like we're running a decent lap, too.
Alright, man.
Okay, there it is. Off we go. Get my keyboard started again. Let me take a quick look at the results. Can I look? Please tell me that's not qualifying. I think it is. Yeah, we may be starting in second place. And a field of people that are definitely faster than us. Yep, that is the case. That is super scary. Alright, well, just have to make the best of it and try and keep it on track.
Good luck, guys.
Easy on these starts. This is a standing start. I think the Advanced Mazda Cup will be a rolling start, which I much prefer. Gives everybody a chance to kind of spread out a little bit. Sometimes it can make even more incidents, but on a track like Summit, not so much. Alright. Wait for the lights. There they are. Try not to spin the tires too much. This car's not too bad with that.
Green, green, green.
Not bad. Alright, 20 laps to get her done. It's just kind of a Spec Miata type format. Actually, a little bit long for a Spec Miata race. Looks like we got people eyeing to move up already. Actually, let's keep it in third. Here he's down there. Looks like we got two of them. Two pink cars rolling through. Oop, he got in the grass there. I may just let him go because I'm worried. Kind of, see, that's the danger of being on the outside of that turn. Kind of caught this fourth place guy out, but I think he'll just be happy that he's in one piece, because I know I am. That's what he gets for not qualifying. He could have started on pole, but he chose not to. Alright, clean so far. Can't hear what he's saying. Hopefully he's not cussing me out. Let me turn him up, actually. Nope, that's not going. Ooh, late into there because of that. Probably let him go. Oh, I forgot downshift. That was the problem. Go ahead. getting a little bit of frame lag there. I think it's just Google Hangouts screwing with me. Nice little gap back to 6th place. I hate that we're losing spots like that, but like I said, there's going to be a very mixed field of people that are this year certainly faster than us. So hopefully we'll just settle in where we belong eventually. And hopefully these leaders keep doing stupid stuff like that and let me by. Take the limiter here. Yeah, you can see that's slowing them down being in this real tight-knit pen. Which is good for me, because this is actually probably like my max speed and their lowest speed. Keeping everything close. Getting a much better run off of there. This is where I feel this setup kind of stinks. It's in that section right there. Let me actually see if I can reach down here and do this. I like to have that up, just to keep myself honest. I can tell if I'm braking way too deep or something like that. Still in fifth. I would be very, very pleased with that.
1 minute.
Into the 125s, that's where I like to be. I was a little deep into one here. Made it up in that last second braking, but certainly not the correct line into there. My shifts are also abysmal, flat shifting most of them, which is not great. Got a thousand other things to focus on. In the dirt like them. I am terrible about that. I'll be following somebody and I'll just choose their line for whatever reason, even if it's terrible. It's a pretty aggressive downshift. Sixth place guy is starting to catch up. As things will sort out here, that'll happen. People start to get into their rhythm. Whew. I still got the shakes. Probably hear it in my voice, just the tense coming out of your voice. It's certainly a whole different world than anything else we do.
1 minute 25.
This is why very, very few people do commentaries, live commentaries in iRacing. Oh, that's scary looking. Oh, that's super scary looking. I don't want to pass any of you guys. You just go ahead. I got nobody behind me. That was a little bit of a pansy move by me, but I am just trying to get back into the things. I don't need to be pushing into situations like that. Oh, he was early on the brakes there. Threw me off. That was pretty defensive. I'll be slow out of here, but there's not much you can do.
All clear.
That's how you defend a line. That was pretty good there. I'm pleased with myself. I had a terrible run out of this turn, though, and that's going to not be good for me. He gave me a little bump there. That's fine. He's using the draft. He's probably going to poke out here down into one. I'll be ready for it. Hopefully try and do a little over-under. Oh, nope, he actually stayed right with me. Oh no, the other guy's going to get in there too. That would not be very good for my lifespan. None of this is going to be good for my lifespan. Ooh, I tried to give him room. I hope I give him enough room.
We're on the right.
No, don't go there.
We're on the right.
Alright. No, I just want to stay here. I don't want to pass you. Okay. Breathe. Just breathe. I'm so glad to be back in cars that I am at least halfway competitive in, though. That was a large reason I kind of got burnt out in iRacing, was those faster cars, you don't get racing like this. They just get a little game freeze there. But yeah, it's not door-to-door racing like this. It doesn't get your heart pumping. Usually it's just a few laps of close racing, and then a bunch of pacing. Keeping these drafts so that these guys don't get a huge run. Oh, he went in there deep. Scared the crap out of me. I did not think he was going to stop in time. Oh, not this again. Why here every time?
Clear on the right.
Alright. That's how it's supposed to happen. They're still dropping like a rock, but it's okay. See all these blue bumpers? That means they are A-level, I believe. I am just a C-level, so I would expect them to be faster than me. So I'm still just filtering back into kind of the area of the pack I belong. No incidents yet. It's impressive. Maybe we'll keep the wallet full for this first week. And this is the one I really expected to have a lot of problems in. Throwing me off there. This is actually a little faster with the draft. I was not shifting into fifth. A little bit different. Alright, sixth place. That's okay. Gotta get back into a rhythm, though. I feel like I'm just following other people's lines. That's never good for you. Finally, getting into this turn without somebody to our inside or outside. Very welcome sight. I feel like this number three, Steven, is much faster than us. Except for this section. This is actually my favorite part of this track. I really like these slow turns. It's all about hitting your marks. Floating all the way through them all. This turn's usually fun, but in the setup it's not been great. My left foot is falling asleep. It's so much more taxing on the body than a set of course. My whole body is just tense. It's gonna take a few weeks for that to go away. If it does at all.
1 minute.
Back in the 25s. That's good.
Seven.
I can use my normal braking points and not have to worry about defending. That is a turn that does not reward driving in deep. Terrible line. Oh, I thought it was going to be our first incident, but it was not. Oof, over rev. That's not good for anybody. Especially our engine. I feel like this guy behind me is actually faster than the two in front of me. But in some sections of the track, I'm able to beat him. I don't know what he's talking about. I'm always paranoid about this game and doing commentary because I'm always paranoid like my mic is open or something like that. I know it pops up on the screen if I'm talking, though, so...
One,
no, it's not the case, but I always think about it in the back of my mind. And how crazy people would think I am. You would think somebody would say something, though, like, shut up, dude. Missed my line. Completely. Let him go. Get back in line. Now we finally have a nice gap behind us for the first time in this race. Even if we have had to drop back to 7th place to do it. Alright, so I've got to think of maybe some other incentives. Currently, if you missed the first part there, or if you just skipped right to the race, it is $1 per incident. That was almost one right there. It is $10 for a clean race and a win, which is not going to be the case here. Not by any means. And if I have to redo the race completely, it is $15 to do that. Some of these races are going to wind up like this one is kind of shaping up to be, where I might just work myself into a nice little pack, and I might get no incidents. Only halfway through though, so that could definitely change. Rack up some incidents in no time. Especially right there, as the tires are wearing. The front does not want to respond anymore. Or if I explode this thing, downshifting incorrectly into this turn. Nice rhythm there. Not too bad. Still wants to push out right there. That is not fun. Not fun to have a car handling that way. Let's go ahead and keep going to 5th there. Just so I stay in that habit. Pushed me on the brakes a little late. I'm actually starting to fall back to the number 10 car and fall away from these three ahead of me. Well, my times haven't fallen off dramatically. Probably break later into here. It'd still be pretty comfortable, but just gotta find my marks. Oh man, loses the nose again. Everybody's gonna be fighting that though. Just gotta not let it bother me. See, I'm much more aggressive on the brakes into this turn than I am in turn one, for whatever reason. It's a pretty good group. I have not heard anybody, like, yelling and screaming or getting upset with anybody, which is, commonplace in these open class kind of races. Tim was catching us, but we appear to have pulled a gap again. Pretty much the correct breaking point through there. Don't think I caught those three in front, but I don't think they left me this time. That was our best lap. 25.7. That was just a good lap. I don't know. Went purple for whatever reason. Purple usually means good in racing. So I should turn them up a little bit more. I always have a turn down because I never know what kind of people you're going to be going up against. I feel like I'm losing a lot of time there. Yeah, look at that. It caught us a ton. keeping him behind us. The gas a little too soon. Really like to hold this spot. That was a little too much curb there. That could be dangerous. The three's kind of fallen off too. He's having the same problems I am, maybe. 8, 4, 5. Missed turn. Missed turn completely.
You got one on your right. Stay left.
Same spot.
On the right.
There he goes. Man. That stinks. How about 50 cents per position lost versus qualifying? That sounds pretty good. Make it more interesting. So if we start on the pole, that would be really bad, say if we finished last, but at most that would be $10 or so. So I think that's a reasonable goal. And if you haven't figured it out by now, I am recording this part before the intro part, so I will have already figured this out in the future. So you'll have already known these rules that I'm making up on the fly. Let's see if we can't get back up to him and put him under a little pressure. Make him make a mistake. We still got a draft this far back. Yeah, pulling up. Terrible up. See, I was not applying enough braking pressure into there. Was the problem? That time I applied too much. That was actually because I was kind of catching him rapidly. Oh, tire of the dirt. That is never good. Going into there. Stretched it back out. To a second. This is where I feel I'm the strongest. So I gotta try and take advantage of that. No. Oh, there's our first incident. Cannot believe the engine survived that though. Into first gear. And terrible response to it. I didn't push in the clutch or anything. Oh, I can't believe it did not blow up. Wow. Okay. Yeah, I'm all flustered. Get my head on straight again. Oh, man. It's okay. It's still running. Did not blow up. Did not wreck. One incident. Now that we are on completely open track, let's actually try and turn down some quick laps. No excuses. Let's stay off this grass over here. Everybody seems to be willing to put their tires out in the dirt out there. I'm sure there's time to be had by doing that, but I am not willing to do so. Third. Second. Very late. There's incident number two. Everything's falling apart now. It was going so well. Probably getting try-hard syndrome. On tires that are not quite as happy as they once were. Refocus. Just focus on hitting the marks. even stupid stuff like that kind of distracts me. Like seeing dust in the distance, I'm like already thinking, okay, where's that car gonna be? Where's the wreck? Even though I see the relative times over there, I know there's not.
9, 2, 9, 5 left to go.
Just 5 to go. And race number 0. Even the brakes feel like they're not working as well. Maybe it's the tires going off, I'm not sure. But I seem to have lost a lot of speed in this car. I've just lost my line, basically. This is where things might get a little quieter, because I really have to focus on driving. To do better in a pack than I do by myself, which sounds weird. Well, look at the times down the straightaway. I don't know if maybe the engine did take a little damage there or not. That doesn't seem like it. He's certainly not catching us. On the short straight there. That was a not so great turn. Still got 1.4.
1:26.9,
that's an awful
three,
lap.
Four.
There we go. That felt normal. See, that was all in my head. It's basically what that means. Absolutely nothing wrong with the car. Everything wrong with the driver. Please stop pushing their car. I beg of you. Still feels pretty good into here. Getting it nice and tight. Tidy. The other setup, I was having some problems with the back end, wanting to wander around through that section. None of that with this setup. Tap of the brakes there just to help set it. We maintained our gap so far this lap, not that better. That better. Good grammar. By golly, we've got an Aussie here. They have really improved the servers and whatnot over the years, because if you got people from Australia racing against North Americans and there's not a lag issue, then you're definitely doing something right. It definitely was not always that way. They even have Australian and European servers now. And usually it kind of separates, which sounds terrible, but it separates people out by country. In these races, you might not always get the chance to do that. Or maybe it just goes to those servers and then to a central server. I don't know. I don't know how it works, to be honest. All I know is we just went green for a part of a sector, which is a first in a while. We're actually starting to increase the gap. Two to go. This time by, that's good words to hear. I'm ready for it to be over. And this isn't even the real thing. This is just a phony race. It means virtually nothing. Pretty deep into there again, but mostly saved it. Looks like he did the same thing because he closed in a bunch under braking. It's usually never a good thing when you see the Delta go super green corner entry. Means you're about to pay the price big time. My feet are going so numb. Getting no blood flow to the feet. It's all going to my noggin. Oof, that was rough. Didn't we just go green in this sector last lap? What happened? Don't like to be out there.
Alright, man. White flag in the line.
Can't wait for it. That was probably a waste. A little bit of trail break in there. Keep the nose. Oh, it looks like he spun. I didn't even notice it. Alright. So, smooth sailing on the last lap here.
1:26.3.
Just gotta keep it pointed the right way. See, we were red most of the way into that braking zone. But then it all caught up right in the center of the turn, and you get back to the throttle rail soon. Makes up for all of it. I still don't feel like I've found the right line through this turn, though. See, this time I paid the price out. Bit strange. Shock those valves one more time. But we'll put it in third so we don't completely destroy them. That could have been a race center right there. I'm a little surprised it wasn't third to first. Oop! There's our first little bit oversteer of the race.
Woohoo! Got it.
Yeah, just let it hit Lemmer.
You're a pretty good race back here, too. Race riding and whatever.
It was a good race.
That was a good race.
I definitely made some mistakes.
Yeah.
But overall, it was a lot of fun. Especially in those first 10 laps or so. Kind of lost my rhythm once we started getting separated out, though. Which does happen. Alrighty, so here's the results of week 0. Here in Let's Race with Cone iRacing, I am in 8th place. We started 2nd, so that means we dropped 7 places at 50 cents a place. That is $3.50 to Child's Play. And incidents, we had 2 incidents, so that is another $2, so $5.50 total. But overall, the stats, we did okay. We were above our iRating, which is nice, which means we get a plus 42 in iRating. And our safety was still pretty darn good, and we got a 1/10 increase, pushing us up to a 3.36, which is fairly okay. 4 is about, 4 to 5 is like perfect levels, and 4, I believe, gives you the ability to promote faster, but I am not at all worried about that. This series will not be about promoting our way through iRacing. It's going to be about enjoying iRacing and enjoying actual, like, competition and racing again. So that is the goal. I do hope you enjoy, and I hope you're looking forward to the start of the real season, which will be next week, with the Advanced Mazda Cup Series, which should look a little bit different than what you saw today, but not dramatically so. And I will be spending a lot more time practicing and that kind of stuff, so hopefully I don't look quite as rusty either. Alrighty, well, thanks for watching, and I will see you next week.